Restaurateurs and small business owners are gathering here on Kent Island, demanding that Governor Larry Hogan reopen the state of Maryland.
Remember, polls remain open here in the state of Delaware until 8 p.m. this evening, and if you are in line before 8 p.m., they have to let you vote.
Protesters are marching in a police-organized demonstration demanding justice in the death of George Floyd.
The most important thing you need to know on this election day is that in order for your vote to be counted, your ballot must be signed on the back and dated June 2nd.
As for how the pandemic will play at the debate tonight, we are told there won't be a handshake between the candidates, and the two podiums were already at least 6 feet apart. Joining me now is Hannah Cecchini. She is a reporter for 47ABC. Hannah, thanks very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
And we're going to for those who may not be aware, can you tell us more about the incident on Church Street on May 26th and the accusations of excessive force used by a Salisbury police officer? Where does that case stand right now?
Don't know. And it's my understanding that a lawsuit is going to be filed, so I am going to reserve comment on that at this time.
I was in Ocean City over the weekend. I noticed a whole lot of people up and down Coastal Highway, a lot of car enthusiasts for what would have been cruising weekend, many of them pulled over by the OCPD. Do you feel as though their presence, the large gatherings that they bring, the burnouts on the roadway in any way take away from Ocean City's reputation as a family-friendly resort town?
Well, I don't think they override our reputation or take anything away. I mean, that's Coastal Highway. I don't think it overrides the overall family image of Ocean City, but it's not something that we'd like to see.
The pandemic is, of course, still raging on, and there are so many folks in our community that are facing food insecurity and hunger, and that is why we have partnered up with radio stations across the country for this all-day Radio Cares Feeding America Radiothon.
With a police escort, hundreds of protesters marched from Salisbury University to the Salisbury Police Department, nearly 3 miles, demanding racial justice and equality. Sparked by the death of George Floyd and the nationwide movement it has caused, protest organizers say this movement is about change.
The purpose of this demonstration is to show the city that we are actually wanting a change now, and we want to sit up here and make things actually really different when it comes down to our council, especially our county council, state's attorney, and everything else when it comes down to the injustice system of the police and everything.
The march has the backing of the Salisbury Police Department, providing escorts, marching with demonstrators, and lending the police headquarters for the demonstration.
We join with them in what we've seen as far as injustices. I mean, we just don't believe the stuff that we couldn't believe for our own eyes what we saw in Minneapolis. And, you know, we stand with them on that. So if it's something that we can offer, we wanted to offer that.
Salisbury's acting mayor, Julia Glenn, says this movement isn't about a single incident, but about systemic racism.
It's important to be out here and show support for these protesters because there's 400 plus years of inequities that we're trying to make up for as a society.
A message echoed by speakers at the demonstration.
The beautiful thing about being from here is that the Eastern Shore of Maryland was the hub of the civil rights movement. And it is time for us to be the hub of the new civil rights movement. We will not die.
Tonight's protest in Salisbury has remained peaceful, a sign that demonstrations on the shore won't end up like what we've seen in big cities across the country. In Salisbury, Hunter Landon for the Delmarva News Network.